shortly get a copy of that. So what I really have to say is contained in the statement itself. There are some important analysis to be made. The first is that the last five quarters had witnessed a downward trend. This marks the reversal of that trend. This additionally indicates that perhaps the impact of two very significant structural reforms, demonetization and the GST, is now behind us, and hopefully in the coming quarters we can look for an upwards trajectory. I think the most significant aspect is the fact that this quarter's positive result has been impacted significantly by the growth in manufacturing. And the last important point is that the fixed capital formation being up to 4.7, which actually means that the investment is moving upwards. This is broadly our initial analysis. Hopefully, we should go back to higher growth rates in coming quarters. If you look at the overall picture, since May 2014, out of the 13 quarters, we've clocked upwards of 7% 8 times. We've fallen below 6% only once, and that was the last quarter. And therefore, if you at all compared this to any previous figure immediately preceding there, this looks entirely different. But then I think the fact that it marks a reversal, it's been enabled essentially by manufacturing, and that investment has moved up, I think, with something which was extremely challenging so far, are the key significant features as far as this growth is concerned.
So,
I think Dr. Adia and maybe Arvind.
So one question to you. When you look at this this trend, revival in the growth trend, how do you see the overall fiscal GDP numbers? The range that you had given in the budget also was a good 6.75 to 7.5. Do you feel that you will close the fiscal year with about